All right, and the United States is stepping up its role in the search for those kidnapped girls in Nigeria. Right now, an additional force of 80 U.S. troops has begun to arrive in Western Africa. Most of them are Air Force personnel. And they're being stationed in the neighboring country of Chad because it's a safer operating base. And because analysts believe that Boko Haram, that radical Islamist group that abducted the 250 girls back in April, is holding the girls captive at various locations around the region. And remember, that's a sizable amount of territory, about the size of West Virginia. A lot of it is comprised of dense, hard-to-search jungle territory. NBC's Bill Neely has been tracking this search for us from Nigeria's capital city, Abuja.
Yes, hello. As the U.S. deepens its involvement in the hunt to find these girls, it is a day of protest here in Nigeria. All schools closed across the country, teachers protesting the lack of progress in finding the girls, but they're also protesting at the attacks of the terror group Boko Haram. They are targets. More than 170 teachers have been killed by Boko Haram. Remember, the terror group targets schools. It believes girls should not be educated in the first place. It believes boys are legitimate targets and that they have a right to kill them, and of course it does kill teachers. Also today, a big protest here in the capital as hundreds march on the president's office. They say he's just not doing enough in the hunt for the girls. Meanwhile, the U.S. has deepened its commitment to finding the girls. A U.S. Predator drone and 80 military personnel are now on the ground in neighboring Chad. They're at an airstrip near the border. The Predator drone is unarmed. More planes may follow. But the Pentagon is stressing that this isn't a combat deployment. As one officer said, we're not out to get Boko Haram, we're out to get the girls. Meanwhile, the death toll from that horrific bombing on Tuesday has now risen to more than 130. And one final footnote, May is now the deadliest month since the Boko Haram campaign began 5 years ago, with more than 450 people killed and the government seemingly powerless to fight them. Back to you.
Thanks to Bill Neely for that. And ahead on today's program.